kolo twale karabadi yando zwala tela bradas nadodosa iniando zwala kora beda zwala basa nata zaza zaza. We bless you, Jesus. Glory to you, Jesus. Ele brede vos, ale de brede vos. We bless you, Father.
Anto
zwala kera beda zwala tale reda brados. Eni kakato ale ketola brege de vos. What a mighty God we serve.
What
an awesome God we have. You are faithful in all your ways.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We exalt you.
Hallelujah.
We magnify you. We say, be thou exalted.
Be exalted, Lord.
We thou magnify.
Hallelujah. We give you praise, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
We bless your holy name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made.
Oh, yes.
We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is Activating Power Prayers, day 18.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. God has been faithful.
We have seen his dimensions every single day.
Actually, this is the reign of his blessing. It is the download of heaven's intention.
Yes.
For you, it's a season for the next 40 days. This is day 18. We are praying and we are praying and we are seeing the power of God. We are seeing our lives prosper spiritually, financially, in every ramification in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So this is day 18. Yeah, this is day 18. And I want to welcome you. I believe God has something in store for us. He's a God who is imminimous. Alabadosha. We bless his name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
And of course, I'm Reverend Jed. And then my beloved Pastor Joy, let's hear the scriptures this morning.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We are reading from the Word of God,
and
the Book of 1 Kings, chapter
18.
We are reading verse 41 all the way down to 46.
In the name
and Elijah
Jesus.
Said unto Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink. For there is a sound of abundance of rain.
Wow.
So Ahab went up to eat and to drink, and Elijah went up to the top of the camel. And he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees and said to his servant, go up now, look towards the sea. And he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. And he said, go again seven times. And it came to pass at the seventh time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot and get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. And it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with clouds and wind, and there was a great rain. And Ahab rode and went to Jezreel. 46. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah.
Wow.
And he gathered up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Wow, what a scripture. This is the 18th day.
Yes.
And I have kept hearing one thing in my spirit. I've just kept hearing one thing. You know, shift. An upward shift, an upward positive shift. You know, if you read that scripture, yes, thank you, Jesus. If you read that scripture, you will find out that six times the word up, it says go up. And he looked up. Up is there six good times. And there's a saying that six is the number for man. I hear the scripture very clearly. The one that says in Psalm 5 verse 6, the Bible says, for promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. He said, but God is the judge of all. He will bring down one and he will lift up another. If you see in that place, you know, it says that, I think it's in verse 45 or so. It says, tell Ahab to go down. Abba Gadash. Tell Ahab to go down. Please, can we see that?
And it
verse?
Came to pass in the meanwhile that the heavens was black with clouds and wind, and there was a great wind, and Ahab rode and went to Jezreel, and the hand of the Lord was Elijah, and he gathered up his loins, Okay.
45, please.
Yeah, I read 45.
Okay, 44. There's okay. a place it says, tell
and it
Ahab.
Came to pass at the seventh time that he said, behold, there arise a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot and get thee down.
Hi, Shando Zadas.
That
he should prepare to go down. Ahab should prepare to go down. I don't know what is an Ahab around your destiny. Ahab is preparing to go down because you are going up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are, the Bible says, he has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly place. The Bible says, he that is above is above all things.
Hallelujah.
I see a shift in your destiny in upward dimension in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There is a saying that up there are no collisions. Mm. Yeah, there are no you don't come to a place where you are in a class of your own. I see somebody shifting upwards.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Today is the 18th day.
Wow.
Every day we are gaining strength. You may be getting a little lean, hallelujah, but you are gaining spiritual strength.
Yeah.
The Bible says this kind cannot go out except by fasting and prayer. Mm. We are fasting, we are praying, and some things that have been hanging are breaking every single day.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we are gaining grounds, we are advancing in the Lord, and we are reading 1 Kings 18. And I always ask man of God, these numbers are in line. What's happening?
Hmm.
And in this story, we are seeing Elijah.
Adabash.
We are seeing Elijah.
Hmm.
Nobody knew how he grew, but he just manifested suddenly. And we saw him, all the drama that went on until this time. And at this time, he said, I am going to meet Ahab. And in Ahab, he said very clearly in verse 41, and Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up. Eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundance of rain. Dwelling in this verse alone, I want to just make something very clear. At this time, they have been there at Mount Carmel on top of the mountain. He has called down the fire, and it is time for the rain to come. The enemies has been judged. In fact, Elijah just finished killing 450 false prophets. Oh my God. He has been exhausted, I believe. Standing from morning till that time of the evening sacrifice and calling down fire. Now he's about to call down the rain. We saw him say something. That was when he told Ahab, and Elijah said to Ahab, get thee up.
Hmm.
Eat and drink. You know, I look at this place, I'm usually angry here. I tell you. When will he tell this adulterous king to get up and eat and drink that he had the son of abundance of rain? I mean, why should he tell him that? Is he his friend? Is he partners with him? But the Lord began to show me the spiritual position of the church. The spiritual position of everyone that's supposed to represent Christ on earth. The spiritual position of every prophet, every servant of God. Because this is the nation at the time that have been overrun by the activities of Baal worship that have replaced the true worship of God. We are living at a time when the true worship of God is being replaced by activities of men. Now Elijah has come to correct that. And as he was correcting that, he was also bringing in something. He told Ahab, arise, get thee up, eat and drink. There is a sound of abundance of rain. You know the truth? The truth is that in this generation, the message of good news is only in the mouth of the church. The good news that will bring about the real change, the scarcity, the perverseness, all the trouble that we are seeing is only in the mouth of the church, only in the mouth of the servant of God, that there will be a reversal. So we saw Elijah on duty. After he told him to get up and eat and drink, he did something. He didn't go to join the eating and drinking. The Bible says he went and cast himself down. Actually, Ahab actually got got up to eat and drink. Can you imagine? But Elijah in the next verse said, he went up to the top of the Carmel and he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees. That was a position of prayer. He cast himself on the ground, he put his face between his knees, and he was there groaning. He was there traveling. I tell you that when you see people in their entertainment and celebration, there is a crop of people who are interceding because they know that God has placed on their shoulder the burden of making sure that their generation is recovered. We are living at a time that what we see and what has been handed over to us must be returned back to the point where we intercede, where we pray, where we, even though they are there eating and drinking, no, we are the ones that make sure that the rain comes down upon us. We are the ones that make sure the fire comes down to confirm the word of God. We are the ones that slay the false prophet. I tell you, yes, you know the prophet Samuel. I was thinking he knows only how to pray, but I saw the man take a sword. He took King Ahab. The Bible says he brought him and he cut him into pieces. I said, wow. We saw how Elijah took the 400 prophets of Baal and single-handedly cut them. I tell you one thing, in this season, the Lord is counting on us to begin to make declarations. What am I talking about? It is the word of God in our mouth that we recover and we bring the heart to the place where they know that the Lord God is God. On this 18th day of our fasting and prayer, we are declaring upon this mountain of prayer that every false oppression in the land is coming down. Every false oppression, false representation of the church, we lift up our voice. I tell you something, they were so numerous. I didn't see the 7,000 that were mentioned that have never bowed their knees. It looked as if these people were outnumbered. We saw the 400 prophets of Baal, we saw 450 priests of Baal, but we did not see anyone that the Lord thought about. Elijah, you're not alone. There are 7,000 that I have who has never bowed, but they didn't show up in this mountain. You know what? He looked as if Elijah was standing alone. There is a call for everyone at this point. You know what? We pray, we keep on praying, but you know what? The assignment has been given to us. In this mountain of prayer, we are declaring that this generation is yet to see another move of God. We are not taking what we are seeing today in the church, where the name of the Lord is being blasphemed, where we see our signs being replaced by ensigns, where we see people making caricature of the activities. When they called and mentioned the name of the Lord in mockery, and the name of the Lord is being profaned, we are the people that are standing and making demand that there will be a restoration to sanity. I tell you something, on this 18th day of this 40 days fast of the rain of blessing, we are breaking the halls of Deku and we are calling down the rain from heaven. Because you know what? There's going to be a rain of revival. Every dryness is going to be over. Everything that I've been making people's hands to be full of blisters in trying to cultivate. You see people struggling, trying to serve God. You see ministries are struggling because there is a dryness everywhere. We declare the rain of heaven is going to come. We declare that every false oppression is coming down. We declare the true church of Jesus Christ is emerging. And in this generation, it doesn't matter the falsehood and the falseness represented. We stand and declare that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now we see that it's a story that consistently affirms the victory of the church, no matter what the contentions are.
Victory.
No matter what the contentions are.
Victory.
Like Pastor Joy rightly said, this was after Elijah had defeated the prophets of Baal.
Slaughtered
and in these 17 days, yesterday we saw bringing down the giants.
Yes.
And we know, of course, of consciously, that the enemy has been brought down.
Matata.
You know why? In the realm of the spirit, every giant against your life has come down.
Amen.
Every giant against your ministry
personally
has come
down.
Every giant against your family has come down. They are coming. They are down already. That's why we said that today you are taking your place.
Amen.
You are shifting in realms. You
Amen.
Are shifting in dimension.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But look at this. We will not just end there. He said, go eat and drink, but he still insisted on going to the place of prayer.
Yeah.
That's why we consistently pray.
We'll
prayer is not because we have gotten our victory or we don't have anything to do. Prayer is our life. Like they say, less prayer, less power. More prayer, more power. So Elijah declared, go and eat and drink. And permit me to say, every time you hear go and eat and drink, it is because something good has happened.
Mm.
God, through the mouth of Eli, said that to Hannah. And I want to say that to somebody, not to digress. I want to tell somebody it is a season of celebrating, not because you are celebrating in iniquity. Mm. No, you are celebrating because there is a victory that you have become.
Hallelujah.
You have received. There
Hallelujah.
Is a good news you have received.
Hallelujah.
In fact, there is a good news that is coming your way that will bring celebration to your life. There is a breakthrough that is coming your way
Amen.
That will bring celebration to your
Amen.
Life. Now look at Elijah knew that there was need for rain. And he told the king to go and be eating and drinking. But he went to command rain to come. He went to the place of prayer. Began to war. Began to wrestle. And by the time he was resting, the Bible says, the hand of the Lord appeared. Adosha. I prophesy to somebody. This season, in the place of waiting, as we are waiting in these 40 days, the hand of the Lord will appear suddenly.
Amen.
Some of you in the next 7 days. Some of you in the next 3 days.
Amen.
Somebody under the next 24 hours. What you thought was impossible to achieve,
your hand shall
collect it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because we know that the contentions of the prophets of Baal, those who are enchanting wickedness, those who are standing to resist you, those who are standing to limit you, the barriers of the wicked one, they are coming down.
Amen.
They are crushing.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And the Bible said, I will go up, for I hear the sound of abundance of rain. I say it again. I am not telling you. I said I will go up because I hear the sound of abundance of rain. Several years ago in 2003, I came. We were holding a meeting in the city of Asaba, that's in Nigeria. And then the power of God came upon me mightily, and I began to declare, I hear the sound of abundance of rain.
Come on.
And there was this young man there, a photographer, just a youth president of a church, and then he had fire for God. And he took that word literally. Do you know the next week they called him from a very massive church and then told him that they were sending him to Lagos. This was somebody who was a photographer and he was becoming a full-time pastor. The whole board of this ministry sat and said it has never happened before. He didn't go through our Bible school. He didn't do this. The headman, the man, the visioner said, that is what God told me. I don't also know him so well. But what I'm trying to say is that there are protocols that will be broken.
Amen.
There are barriers that will be broken. Mm. I see you being called to places you never imagined you will arrive. I see the things you thought you would see in 10 years, in 5 years, in 3 years, appearing within 1 week, within 1 month, because I hear the sound of abundance of rain.
Hallelujah. Verse 43 said, and said to his servant, go up now, look towards the sea. That is a particular destination and direction.
Yes.
And he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. And he said, go again seven times.
Mm.
You are looking at something and seeing nothing. God has given you direction. He has pointed at a direction. You are looking, you are seeing nothing. The 18th day is here.
Mm.
He looked as if you are not seeing anything yet. He said, go again seven times.
Mm. Mm.
It's not necessarily the number. Seven represents perfection. I tell you something. The Bible says it came to pass at the seventh time.
Mm.
And it said, behold, there arises a little cloud out of the sea. Like a man's hand.
Shabbatas.
And it said, go up. Son to Ahab, prepare the chariot. How can he see some little cloud that is like a fist of a man. And he concluded there will be abundance of rain. You take faith. It takes faith.
Yes. From a different realm.
From seeing nothing to seeing a little opening. Come on, go ahead and declare what you have heard God say. From seeing nothing. He saw nothing before. Then he saw a little fist like a man's hand. But he was referring to abundance of rain. I tell you, when he mentioned that, the Bible said in the meanwhile, instantly, suddenly, the whole cloud was darkened. Because he said it. He did not say what he saw. How can the fist of a man suddenly become darkened
clouds? Mighty clouds.
Yesterday we talked about faith.
Yeah.
Today we are referring again to this point of faith. Don't say what the situation is saying. When you see nothing, you don't say nothing, because God did not say nothing.
Say something.
God has said, I hear something. What you are hearing may be different from what you are seeing. You need to say what you have heard the Lord say. You need to repeat the situation that God has said. You don't need to repeat again what you are seeing. You need to say what you hear. You say, go again the second, seventh time. Until you agree with the word of God, that is perfection. Until you agree with what God said, that is perfection. This morning, somebody is going to come into agreement with the perfection of the word of God. The Bible says seven times the word of God is purified. The fires of the earth. You need to agree with the word of God. You need to come to the place of perfection and say, Father, I'm tired of confessing negatively. Somebody's health is on the line right now. You need to confess
the word of God.
The word of God. He said, by his stripes I am healed. I may be seeing a little fist. I'm only a little better, but that symptom is still there. You need to believe the word of God. You see the situation that looks as if nothing is going to come out of it. You need faith to declare. I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. I may have been coming and seeing nothing, but this 18th day, I see a little fist of a man's hand. But I'm going to declare the word of God. Did you hear me?
I see a word. Malagush.
You are seeing nothing, but you hear the sound of abundance of rain. And today, the Lord is saying, you may see a little fist of the hand, but you have to declare. In the meanwhile, the man he told to gather and run, he was still trying to enter his chariot when the heavens were darkened. Instant sudden change.
Transformation.
Hallelujah. They're going to pray.
Yes.
But I want to talk about speed. Because somebody is going to resist speed.
In the name of Jesus.
Somebody is going to resist speed. In the meanwhile, the heavens were darkened. Before Ahab could enter his chariot to begin to run, the Bible says the hand of the Lord, hallelujah, came upon Elijah.
In the name of Jesus.
And he began to run. Elijah began to run. Man of God, he began to run.
He did not just run.
His 2 feet.
He outran the chariot.
His 2 feet.
Agolada.
I mean you, in your only 2 feet. People may have been in systems you are not in. But the speed of the Almighty is taking you to overtake.
My God.
The hand of the Lord came upon him. You're going to trust God for the hand of the Lord.
Yes.
But first you must come into agreement.
Yes.
The perfection of the agreement.
Yes.
Of the word of God.
In
the prayer. I
want to say this. I want to take a cue from something you said.
Yes,
as we are preparing to round up.
Yes.
Now listen to this. The Bible said Elijah told the servant to go again.
Go again.
Sir, what is not working? Go again.
Go again.
What did you fail in? Go again.
Go again. Pray again.
What did you not see? Go again. Alabadaba. What is what was denied you? Go again. You thought you have lost. Permit me to announce to you. Go again. You thought you have missed that opportunity. Go again. Felt you were rejected. Go again. You thought that you cannot get that proposal. Go again. Whatever it is that it looked like has been denied you.
Go again.
That is, I feel that word burning in my spirit.
Yeah.
I need to tell somebody you go again. And when you go again, you are going to see the hand of a man.
Hallelujah.
Now, why is it the hand of a man?
The
Bible
said
that from man, who are thy hand? I see you as you go again. Strategic men have been positioned in your destiny.
Yes, yes,
strategic
yes, yes.
places have been opened for
come
you. Strategic favors are waiting for
come
you.
Now,
strategic
now.
Opportunities are happening
men
for you. There
hand,
is
people.
A saying that a breakthrough is when preparation meets with opportunity.
Aye.
Prepare your mind. Go again. Prepare your documents. Go again.
Yes.
Prepare your proposal. Go
again.
Prepare your CV. Go again. Prepare yourself.
Yeah,
go
God,
again.
God, God,
this
God,
time
God,
you are
God, God,
coming
God.
Back with result.
Amen.
Anabala Kosha.
Man,
you are coming back. Yes.
Supposed to go again.
Ain't no coach.
But the depression, I saw it
Ain't
on
no
the
sir.
Shoulders of a man who is among the group of people that are being commanded to go again. But the heavy weight, a heavy spirit of depression is hanging over his shoulder. He's hearing this word, go again, but he doesn't have what it takes in him for him to go again. Father, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of depression, rejection,
suppression, in Adush.
It's broken.
In the name of
in
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Broken.
You will arise and go again.
Yes,
and this time you will have results.
In the name of Jesus.
This time you will come back with testimony.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hayabakuto.
Go again and
go
come
again.
Back with your testimony.
In the name, you just said that. And,
hey.
And I while you were saying that, I also heard that somebody, you have decided not to check your email out of pain. Say there's nothing, no need. But this time around, you are getting that expected email.
Amen.
Go again to your email check box.
Again.
There is a miracle that just arrived.
Amen.
What blocked you yesterday? By yesterday it arrived. You didn't see. But check now. Check now. There is an email, a confirmation email to that job that has arrived. There is a just go back again to your email.
Hallelujah.
Go back again. There is a confirmation message. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you.
In Abada. But look at this. The Bible said that Elijah went to pray. It is when you go to pray that the hand appears.
Yes.
The first prayer to pray is the prayer to receive Jesus.
If you don't have
then
Jesus,
the hand of mercy appears. If you don't have Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. Because it is only when you have Jesus that speed can come in. So
yes.
We are praying. Very quickly, say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I know that I'm a sinner.
I know I'm a sinner.
I've heard your word today.
I've heard your word today.
From this moment.
From this moment.
Every life of sin.
Every life of sin.
I ask that I be forgiven.
That I'll be forgiven.
I reject the life of sin.
I reject the life of sin.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
I accept
Jesus.
You
I accept
as my Lord,
as my Lord
and personal Savior.
And personal
give, me
Savior.
Give
me the grace
to live for you,
to work for you.
Forever. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus
Amen. We're praying. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus
today
I receive grace
for your hand to come upon me.
For speed
of accomplishment.
In
the name of Jesus.
In
every area of my life. Can we pray? Kapala. Lord, let your hand. Kala, kola, pa.
Nada, guala, kola, pela, kata.
Jakwa, twala, kala, pele,
kata. In the name of Jesus.
Na keke, twaleke, tola, praka, twala,
kata. Zaga,
bale, kola, pas.
In the name
of
Jesus.
Jesus,
we declare
Hallelujah. This
day is a blessed
it's
day
a blessed
for you
day.
As you go into your
in
business,
the name of
go
Jesus.
Into your day,
Anna
we call
Kola
it blessed. We break the hold of evil. We break
Swaka
the hold of
Bode.
Evil. We Zaka break Tula. The hold of evil.
In the
go forth
in
and shine forth for your
in
God.
In the name of
in
Jesus.
The name of
you
Jesus.
Are changing rhymes.
Hallelujah.
I perceive that strongly.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go, the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Our numbers are there. You can always send us
prayers.
Messages. Yeah.
We continue. We still have some 22 days to go. Amazing days.
Yes.
And I tell you, every day is awesome. Every day has its own package. By the end of these 40 days, you will not be able to recognize the dimension you'll be operating in.
In the
God
name of
you.
Jesus.
If you have not been
God
fasting, continue. And I want to encourage all those that have been fasting, continue that from this evening. You start
six
and then
o'clock and
6
then
o'clock
by
in by 6 in the evening you start and you break the following day by 12.
Hallelujah.
And the Lord will strengthen you.
God bless
you. In the name of Jesus. Have a wonderful day. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.